out of your seats. Let's warm this place up a little bit.
Thank you. Scripture out of Isaiah 53, following in the spirit of the house, it says in verse 5, but he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was a chastisement that brought us peace, and with his wounds we are healed. There is promise of healing through God's word, through the sacrifice of Jesus. We can have internal healing, physical healing, and it is just available today as it was back then. He has empowered us through his Holy Spirit for us to share his gospel message, and we have the opportunity to do so. So as you come down to the altar, you can put your prayer requests in the God box, or as you take communion on the tables on both sides, remember the sacrifice that Jesus made for us, that through his shed blood, we are free. We are eternally in his hands to be with him forever. And through that shed blood, there is power for redemption and there is power for healing in your life. Amen. So let's pray. Father, I thank you for your son, Jesus, that through his mercy, through his shed blood, we found redemption. We found the loving kindness of heaven that was poured out onto us that we did not deserve. So may you continue to move in this place, and may you do a special work in our hearts, that you may continue to sanctify us. As your word says, we hold on to your promises, and we thank you for that. In Jesus' name, amen. You may come down. rose, so that we would know, we would believe that you sent him, and that his miracle is here and it is alive today in us, the miracle of your grace. And so we revel in that fact, and we are so humble that you would use us, lowly vessels, broken vessels, sinful vessels, to share your gospel and the work of your kingdom. Now may you continue to be glorified. May you help us to understand your word and give us the courage to share with one another, with our neighbors, with the city, and into the ends of the earth. We thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.